The renovation works for Mandela National Stadium are near completion ahead of the official handover to the government, expected in September 2024. Lieutenant Colonel Peter Seku Chidemoka, the project engineer for Mandela National Stadium renovation works, says the project for the renovation of the Mandela National Stadium started in December 2021 and has been executed in a phased manner by the UPDF Engineering Brigade as the main contractor.
This work started some time back, 2021, December. It was phased. First phase was to secure the land because it had been encroached on. So we came here with a directive to ensure that the land is recovered from encroachers, and we gazetted it by putting a perimeter wall. That first phase cost was 3.8 billion, which was paid to us fully, and we really executed the work worth that money.
Lieutenant Colonel Chidemoka says the renovation team is putting the final touches on the National Stadium. He further details the unique features that have been installed to match up with modern and international standards.
The project has been really executed well since 2021 in phases. We are almost turning towards the end and completion. The cost is 94 billion and we have not revised.
At the time of filing this report, the contractor was working on the athletics track and putting the final touches to the pitch. Lieutenant Colonel Chidemoka says that 94 billion project is on course with all parameters observed to meet FIFA and CAF standards. He adds that the facility will be due for handover very soon. Following a protest by Katabi Town Council authorities over garbage trucks that started to dump garbage at the Nkumba dumping site as an alternative for Chitezi without their consent, yesterday Lord Mayor Elias Lukwago engaged with leaders in Katabi to resolve the matter. After a closed-door meeting, Katabi Town Council Mayor Kalema Ronald revealed the outcome of the meeting, which allows KCCA to dump garbage at the Nkumba site, but with conditions attached to the Memorandum of Understanding. According to Kalema, KCCA has been granted permission to dump at this site for 1 month only, as they seek a long-term solution.
Following, we are resolved to address the challenges faced at the site. Grading the road leading to the dumping site by KCCA to facilitate easy access. Provision of water powers that regularly water the road and prevent dust pollution. Involvement of deployment of excavators to the dumping site to manage waste disposal. Reduction of speed limits and restriction of entrance to the dumping site.
Lukwago lauded the Katabi authorities for the gesture and promised to abide by the set conditions in the Memorandum of Understanding. He says KCCA authorities are set to meet today to come up with a lasting solution to the garbage disposal.
We are very grateful to the mayor and his entire leadership here for accepting to accommodate us at least for 1 month. We are really very, very, very appreciative. I want to register our progress, the leadership of the camp, but it was not intentional, it was not deliberate. We wouldn't want to undermine anybody. And we take leadership seriously.
Following the collapse of the Chitezi landfill in which lives were lost and scores injured, the dumping site has been decommissioned to prevent the furtherance of the tragedy. KCCA trucks started dumping city garbage at Nkumba without consultation with the Katabi Town Council. This caused a row which has now been settled through the signing of the MOU today. In international news, thick grey smoke engulfed Mount Pelikas dominates Athens as the Greek capital battled in inferno fallout from what promises to be its hottest summer on record. A 30-kilometer-long line of fires was moving towards Athens, reports said, and one has already engulfed the mountain, also known as Mountain Pentelikon, famed for the marble used in the Acropolis and other ancient buildings in Athens. The nearby historic town of Marathon has also been ordered to evacuate. Brick homes on roads leading to the marathon had huge black stains up the sides of their walls left by the flames. Their roofs had been turned to cinders. At Dion, the fire burned cars and crept up the walls of apartment blocks. Some residents say they fled their cars just as the flames sped up their homes. People in Penteli, an Athens suburb at the foot of 1,109 meters, Mountain Pentelikas could only watch helpless as fierce summer winds pushed flames towards their homes and up the slopes. Thick smoke from burning trees filled Apenteli Square, where resident Mariana said they could only pray that their houses would be spared. Greek authorities have thrown hundreds of firefighters with trucks and water-carrying aircraft into what has become an annual battle as global temperatures soar. After the warmest winter on record, Greece also experienced its hottest June and July since reliable data collection began in 1960. And the summer season has already set repeat blazes. Temperatures around Athens were forecast to peak at 39 degrees Celsius on Monday, with wind gusts up to 50 kilometers per hour. Scientists say the human-induced fossil fuel emissions are worsening the length, frequency, and intensity of heat waves around the world.